Hello my dear friends and welcome to StudyIQ. I am Joycey Joy and today in this lecture we will discuss about deepening India-Japan relationship. Now firstly coming to the current affair. In the recent times there is evidence of improving the India-Japan relationship. So the improvements are visible. But even though there are improvements, there is a huge potential that lies ahead for both the countries in order to improve the bilateral relationship. Both India and Japan can benefit out of improving the bilateral relationship between both these countries. So India must take advantage of this situation and show much more interest in engaging in a bilateral relationship with Japan. So we will discuss about the potential and the scope of improving the bilateral relationship between both these countries and how India can benefit out of it. Now let us briefly understand what are the existing bilateral ties between India and Japan. First one, the infrastructure. So coming to the infrastructure, between the year 2000 and 2017, so in this period of 17 years, Japan has invested around $25.6 billion in India in domains like infrastructure, retail, textiles, consumer durables, etc. And also, if we take the infrastructural projects, we will see that mega infrastructural projects like the Delhi-Mumbai Industrial Corridor, Ahmedabad-Mumbai Bullet Train. So, all these mega projects have got a significant involvement from Japan. So, the infrastructural investment is very significant. And also, Japan has set around 12 industrial parks across different states in the country. And also India has signed a joint high-speed rail project with Japan, and for which the first installment of 5,500 crore was released by Japanese Industrial Cooperation Agency. So in the infrastructure front, we will see that India has highly benefited from investment from Japan, and Japan is also involved in mega projects in India like the DMIC, Delhi-Mumbai Industrial Corridor, Mumbai-Ahmedabad Bullet Train Project, etc. Now coming to defense cooperation, India and Japan had hosted various bilateral exercises. So for example, if we take the recent examples, naval cooperation between Indian Navy and the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force had held recently in the Indo-Pacific region. Now coming to the developmental projects, these two countries, India and Japan, together both these countries have constituted the Japan-India Act East Forum. And the objective of Japan-India Act East Forum is to spearhead development cooperation in northeastern states. The northeastern states that borders with China, Bangladesh and Myanmar. And also the Japan Industrial Cooperation Agency, the JICA, they have signed a $610 million pact with the central government of India for the phase 1 of Northeast Connectivity Projects. So in infrastructure building, defense cooperation and developmental projects, Japan has got a significant role in India. Now let us understand what is the significance of Indo-Japan relationship. Now coming to India and Japan, both these countries are confronting with challenges with a volatile global order in the Indo-Pacific region. That means the instability in the Indo-Pacific region is challenging both the economies, India and Japan. So they can play a mutual cooperation role, or mutual cooperation between these countries in multiple fronts can be helpful for both the countries in order to maintain stability in this region. And they have collective interest in many areas like security, cooperation, trade, infrastructure, developmental projects, etc. And this collective interest of both the countries is visible from the reciprocal state visits witnessed in the recent years. Now, for example, if we consider the JEE grouping, that is Japan, US and India, this summit was held in the sidelines of G20 summit of 2018, which was held in Argentina. So this JEE stands for Japan, America and India. And the first meeting was held during the G20 summit of 2018. So here, under the JEE grouping, what we observe is that these three countries who are involved in the grouping, they have common values, because three of these countries are democracies. So their values are the same, and there is also a convergence of interest. This convergence of interest lies in ensuring the security, stability and prosperity in the Indo-Pacific. And the manner by which China is expanding its presence in the Indian Ocean region, especially in the South China Sea, has become a concern for all these three countries. So they have a common interest in countering China as well. And in the J meeting, three of the countries have said that their objective would be to ensure a rule-specific Indo-Pacific. So, broadly, these three countries share the common objectives of inclusive growth in the region. That means the growth should reach out to all the countries in terms of investment, infrastructure, economic development. So, there is a huge potential and scope for this grouping of J, Japan, America and India. So, here we will see that Japan and India has many common values, many common interests and many common objectives. So, this can be effectively utilized. Now, coming to the national sentiments. In both the countries, we will also see a right-wing nationalist sentiment. So, these are the common areas where they can work together and these are the common interests both these countries share with each other. So, considering all this, Indo-Japan relationship is very significant. Now, let us understand what is the status of China-Japan relationship. The China-Japan bilateral trade equals to around $300 billion in the year 2017. So, from 2016 to 17, this has witnessed a 15% increase. So, there is an improving or increasing trade relation between China and Japan. And also, the Japanese Logistics Corporation has partnered with its Chinese to open up a trial logistics route from eastern coast of China to Western Europe and Central Asia. And what lies ahead for China-Japan relationship is that China has got involved into a trade war with US. So, this can impact the Chinese trade. And therefore, China is willing to partner with other regional powers. So, Japan can be one target of China where China wants to improve the trading relation or the bilateral relationship. Now, coming to the opportunities before India in improving the Japan-India bilateral relationship. The first one, let us understand about the J, which we have already discussed in this lecture. J is Japan, America and India Trilateral Summit. This was held on the sidelines of the G20 Summit 2018, which was held in Argentina. So, under the J, we have seen the common objective is to create a free and open Indo-Pacific. So, India can make utilization of this opportunity. Now, the second one is the Quad. Quad refers to Quadrilateral Security Dialogue. And this is between four countries, India, United States, Japan and Australia. So, India can make use of this grouping as well. And the third one is the common geopolitical interest between India and Japan. So, they share common geopolitical interest and this can also be utilized by India in order to enhance the bilateral relationship between India and Japan. You can find the PDF of this lecture on my Facebook page and for any queries regarding your UPSC preparations, you can get in touch with me on my Facebook page or you can email me at joyce.studyiq@gmail.com. Thank you.